Good evening everyone. My topic is demonetization. So let's first look on the fact that what is demonetization? Withdrawing units of money from circulation is demonetization. Units of money are denied the status of legal tender. Demonetization is defined as a process by which currency units will not remain legal tender. The currency units will not be taken as valid currency. Demonetization is a step taken by the government where currency units are seized of the status as legal tender. Demonetization is a basic condition to change national currency. In other words, demonetization can be said a change of currency where new units of currency replace the old ones. It may involve the introduction of new notes or coins of the same denomination or completely new denomination. The currency has been demonetized twice in India. The first demonetization was on 12th January 1946 Saturday, second on 16th January 1978 Monday, and third was on 8th November 2016 Tuesday. Demonetization means withdrawing the legal tender rights of any denomination of currency. Units of money have deprived the status of legal tender. Demonetization is an act of taking away the legal tender rights of any currency. The units of currency will not be considered as legal currency. The government believes that this currency ban is required for the four main reasons: to control inflation, to fight against corruption, to remove counterfeit currency, and to discourage the cash transaction. Developing country like India has to find a solution to come out of the problem like this for betterment of the country. The government needed to keep the decision secret so that tax evaders would not be aware of this cleanup mission before the announcement of demonetization took place. The reasons of demonetization were black money. Demonetization was a bold and revolutionary action taken by the government of India to curb black money, and one that will have deep impact on the parallel economy in the country. Pockets and persons with black money can be identified with this move. A few businesses like property dealers, jewelers, foreign currency dealers, private money lenders generally hold huge amounts of unaccounted money in form of currency notes. Such unaccounted money had created a parallel economy in the country. Such illegal money has reached the bank accounts through direct or indirect channels. To hit the fake currency rackets, fake currency notes have been wasted by the demonetization. Withdrawing highest currency notes out of the economy will have serious impact on the fake currency syndicates, thus putting an end to the terror funding in Jammu and Kashmir, Naxalite-hit states and northeastern states. The fake currency with racketers have been left in vain, and new currency notes with high security making a counterfeit impossible. Online transactions. Demonetization's motto was to encourage the cashless digital economy. More and more cashless or less cash transactions will lead to more dispersal of income, which will increase the indirect tax collections. With a reduction in cash transactions, alternative forms of payment will be more in demand. Electronic mode of payment like online transaction, payment through applications, e-wallets, e-banking, usage of debit and credit cards, etc. will surely see a substantial increase in demand. Rise in GDP. Food demonetization has negatively impacted sectors such as real estate and property, construction and household consumption in general. It is believed that long-term benefits for GDP growth will outweigh the short-term transitional impact. Sector-wise impact of demonetization were real estate and property. This sector was the most affected sectors by note ban. Demonetization has finished the businesses of the majority of builders, as a major portion of the transaction depends on cash rather than based on banks transfer or checks transactions. Gems and jewelry. Substantial portion of the payment by customers involves cash for purchasing jewelry, so the impact of demonetization in the sector is quite high. Demonetization made people with less cash available in their hands fulfilling their daily needs that are on purchasing jewelry. Small retailers in the unorganized sector were the most to be impacted, which reduced the demand for jewelry. Banks. Banks have proved to be the backbone of this entire process of demonetization and also the biggest beneficiaries. As on the direction of government, old notes have to be exchanged with the new ones. This resulted in increased liquidity position of banks, which could be utilized for lending. Both deposit and lending rates have been cut by many banks. Media and entertainment industry. Currency ban adversely impacted the media and entertainment industry, as it resulted in lesser number of viewers. The majority portion of drop has been seen in the lower middle class. Hospitality and tourism. due to demonetization, Indian tourism have been severely impacted as the majority of spending is in cash. Most of the luxury foreign trips are sponsored by black money and had come to a halt. Luxury items. Demonetization had a drastic impact on this sector. Majority of the people spend their unaccounted money on luxuries. Luxury segment of allied business like clothing, electronics, luxury cars, jewelries had a huge setback. Automobiles, retail were some of the other sectors that were hugely impacted. Labor intensive sectors. In order to pay daily wage laborers, huge amounts of cash is required. They had faced problems buying this routine stuff. Limitations of the withdrawal amount from the bank was affecting the weekly payment to contract personnel in mining, textile and leather industries. Impact of demonetization on the Indian economy. Now we come to the positives and negatives. Positives were black money. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on a single stroke had choked out the black money of the total currency, which is rupees 17 lakh crore. Rupees 3 lakh crore was estimated as black money. Operators of black money run a parallel economy which weakens the base of the country's economy. Modi's demonetization decision resulted in the collection of huge deposits with the bank. All unaccounted money has either been deposited into the banks with the heavy penalty or been simply destroyed. Economy. This demonetization has proved to be a turning point for the economy by cleaning up the black money, which in turn has brought more borrowings to treasury, improved inflation outlook and increased GDP of India. Investment opportunities have also been revived and give a boost to infrastructure and the manufacturing sector. Real estate. It is said that real estate is an industry prospects on black money. The amount of illegal money involved in this sector is huge. An estimate tells us that in Delhi NCR, at least 40% of real estate deals are in black. Modi's demonetization move reduced the flow of unaccounted money into the real estate sector. This will help in curtailing the use of black money in real estate sector, which in turn results in the reduction of the prices of land and property. Hawala transactions. Demonetization was a big thrash to the hawala racketeers. In hawala, money is transferred without its actual movement. Hawala had become the route to facilitate money laundering and terror funding. Hawala rackets run on black money. Sudden withdrawal of black money out of the economy was a surgical strike to hawala operations. Terror financing. The main source of terror financing is through counterfeit currency and hawala. Fake currency is circulated by the network of hawala operators. These hawala operators have a link with gamblers and smugglers of arms and drugs. Indirectly, they all end up financing terrorism. So, demand doesn't help curtail those. Counterfeit currency. Demonetization was a mighty blow to the counterfeit Indian currency. Currency with syndicate operator operating both inside and outside the country has been wasted. Counterfeit currency is one of the main reasons behind the devaluation of real worth of Indian currency. India's Statistical Institute reported that any point of time, fake currency and notes amounting to rupees 400 crore were in circulation in the economy, and around rupees 70 crore fake currency notes are pushed into the country every year. But the real number could be much larger. With the demonetization move, the counterfeit moves were curtailed to a larger extent. The negatives of demonetization were liquidity crisis. It gave rise to liquidity problems as people found it difficult to get sufficient amount of cash to fulfill their basic needs. Marginal section of society mainly depends on cash to meet the daily transactions. The loss of well-being. Most of the population who constitute a lower middle and lower class uses this currency to meet the daily transactions. Such class of society, such as daily wage laborers, small traders, and other marginal sections of the society, use cash more often. So they lost their income in the scarcity of cash. Consumption. Cash shortage adversely affected the consumption of behavior of people of India. Sales of consumer durables likely were hampered in the short term, especially sales to unorganized channels such as cash purchases. Decrease in GDP. Withdrawal of the highest currency notes reduced the growth rate of the economy. So it reduced consumption patterns, income, investment. So it brought a slowdown in India's growth rate. So conclusion of the whole partisan thing was, the move by the government to demonetize old currency and replacing it with new one had taken the country by surprise. The move was an effort to handle the threat of illegal money, corruption, terror funding and counterfeit currency. Currency was considered as a surgical strike against the undeclared money in the history of Indian economy. It may be a move towards the cashless economy. Demonetization was followed by a liquidity crunch in the country. Banks and ATMs across the country faced severe cash shortages with detrimental effects on various small business, agricultural and transportation. The currency ban by the government of India created chaos in short term, as most people with old currency notes faced difficulties exchanging them in long queues outside banks and ATMs across India. Total value of old currency notes in circulation was to the tune of ₹14.2 trillion, which constitute about 86% of total value in circulation. The black money had either been accounted by paying heavy taxes and penalties or had reached the banks through direct and indirect channels. Demonetization brought a positive impact on Indian economy as it encouraged the digital mode of payment like e-wallets, Paytm apps, online transactions using e-banking, usage of plastic money, etc. Demonetization was conclusively beneficial for the economy in the medium to long term. Thank you.